your home heating upgrade options on this episode of Winnipeg's Real Estate Podcast.
You're listening to Winnipeg's Real Estate Podcast with Beau Kaufman of RE/MAX Performance Realty, answering questions for buyers and sellers of homes and condos in Winnipeg.
Hello, this is Beau Kaufman, RE/MAX Performance Realty, your residential real estate agent in Winnipeg. And I always say Beau knows real estate, but there's a lot of stuff that Beau don't know. And for example, Beau don't know furnaces, which is why today, for the first time, we've got an expert in the field of heating and air conditioning on our show. I've invited Dustin Reddy from Balkan & Sons. Balkan has been around for about 75 years to talk about the different options that people have for upgrading or replacing their current furnace systems in their home. All right, so we're here with Dustin Reddy from Balkan & Sons. Welcome, Dustin. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, Beau. Thanks for having me. Like you said, I'm with Balkan & Sons Plumbing and Heating. I've been in the industry for approximately 10 years now, and for the last little while, it's been with Balkan & Sons. And Balkan & Sons is a 75-year-old company, family-owned for now three generations going on to the fourth and feasibly the near future. Yeah, we do plumbing, heating, air conditioning, ventilation, duct work, you name it in the HVAC industry, we do it.
Okay, I understand hot water tanks as well. Okay, so let's talk about a little bit about people's options when they replace their furnace. So you got somebody whose furnace is 25 years old and they want to replace it. What's some of the most cost-effective or inexpensive way to do that?
The most inexpensive way to replace a furnace would be to replace it with something we would call a single-stage furnace with a PSC motor. So essentially, that furnace would literally be the furnace that they currently have built to today's standards. Typically, works the same way, everything's the same, except now it's a high-efficiency version. And going from there, you can go one step up to something with an ECM motor, a more cost-effective motor as far as electricity goes, and they've been known to use as little as 30% less than the typical one that you would get starting out.
Okay, and the brand name that you guys mostly carry is?
We use Lennox. Lennox is our flagship brand, and with the invention of the steel riveted furnace, they're definitely well known since 1890, in the 1890s.
All right, so we've got, that's the basic, the entry level, on-off type of furnace. What about the next level? Where do we go up from there?
The next level, you would go up to what would be called a two-stage furnace. As far as Lennox goes, that would be their Elite series. So quieter, better built, longer lasting. And with a two-stage furnace, you'd now have more like a low heat and a high heat, a different from the single stage furnace where it's 100% of the gas all of the time. So what a two stage furnace will do is it's going to run at a lower capacity of gas usage, allowing for more heat to get to different areas of the house, keeping it much more even throughout the house, as well as warmer days using a lot less gas, because the second stage is mainly for those colder days where you really need 100% of the capacity.
So then this second type of furnace does save people a little bit on the gas bill. And explain to me how that works.
Well, when you think about it, when you have two stage, meaning the first stage will be a lower capacity, usually just over half the gas that the furnace can provide, and then the second stage being the most. So you got to remember, when we size a furnace for the home, we're sizing it for the coldest day of the year. Now, the coldest day of the year, reality is usually about a week or two at the most. So technically, every other day, the furnaces are oversized. So when you get those days that are warmer out, like we're seeing in March right now, you don't need 100% of the gas to heat the home. So that's where you start saving some extra money there.
All right, fantastic. And I think there's something that I would call the Cadillac in the furnace industry. What's the best, the top-level furnace? What are all the bells and whistles?
Well, the best furnace out there, typically by all manufacturers, would be what's called a variable capacity furnace or a modulating furnace. For lack of a better term, these furnaces are usually between 60 and 65 stages of heating, allowing it to use more gas or less gas as it's needed. So I typically will use cruise control for a car as the analogy for it, being, you know, when you're driving down the highway at 100 kilometers an hour, when you get to a hill, cruise control will automatically start increasing the gas to stay at the same speed. So it's sort of like that, wherein the outside weather is our hill. The colder it is, the bigger the hill, and we're going to need more gas to keep the same temperature in the house. The warmer it is, we won't need as much gas. So what that's doing is it's allowing the furnace to run longer using a lot less gas, and it even evens out the temperatures in the house more, maximizing your savings and a lot less noise as well.
And I imagine a lot more comfortable as well in the long run. Okay. So I've got a friend, a brother-in-law of the neighbor's uncle's best man at his wedding, and he does install furnaces on the side, and he offered to do it for just a couple of $100. Is that a good idea?
Not at all. The industry, what we want to do is you want to use a professional contractor to do the work in your home, because there's warranties that's involved. There's after install service. And the problem is your uncle, your brother-in-law's uncle, and however far that goes down the line, is what's he doing on Christmas Day if something happens, or what's he doing at 4 a.m. if something happens? When you have a professional contractor, it's almost like our oath to you that we'll be there for you with whatever happens, then providing guarantees, warranties, all the service after the fact. And instead of having one guy in a van at your disposal, now you have a fleet of 30, 35 vehicles that can come at any time of the day.
All right, so we've been talking about forced air furnaces, and I occasionally get listings in like the River Heights or the older parts of the city where houses built in the 20s and 30s, they still got the old boiler in the basement. And I'm talking about like the big round ball with the spike sticking out. It looks like a space shuttle. What are those people's options? Because they don't have a duct system installed in the house. So what can they do to replace that 80-year-old boiler?
Believe it or not, there still are boilers available, and we still do install quite a bit throughout the seasons. They can go with high-efficiency boilers or mid-efficiency boilers. There's, if they want to, they can do a forced air system, which typically would cost a little bit more, but you can do it. Most of the people who do change to forced air systems will live in a bungalow-style home, whereas the two-story, 100-year-old homes, it's generally more feasible just to change the boiler. And, you know, there's still high efficiency out there, so the savings are still there to be had.
All right, Dustin. Well, thank you very much for coming on and letting us know.
Thanks so much for having me, Bo.
Well, that was our first time that we've had a guest on the show. I do plan to do more of these in the future, perhaps a window expert, a roofing expert, plumber, electrician, that kind of thing. So if you've enjoyed it, please give us a 5-star rating on iTunes or Stitcher, and check us out on our website at rivercitypodcast.com. Till next time, bye-bye.
We hope you've enjoyed this episode of Winnipeg's Real Estate Podcast. All episodes are available on iTunes and Stitcher. When you're ready to buy or sell a house or a condo in Winnipeg, contact Bo Kaufman at RE/MAX Performance Realty at 204-333-2202 or email at bonoshomes@gmail.com.